Nominated actress who stars as Cinderella in a new film entitled Into the Woods. It's in theaters on Christmas Day. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the lovely Anna Kendrick. Anna. I've seen you in big movies.
Great, I'm so glad.
Now you're in another big movie, the Into the Woods. Huge cast, tremendous cast, and you're Cinderella. So I would think Cinderella kind of like the star of the whole thing. Am I right about that?
No, Meryl Streep's the star, which is fine. I mean, I wasn't happy about it, but that's fine.
Nobody's
happy
about it, for heaven's sakes. Yeah, I guess so. Singing, a lot of singing in the film?
Yeah, tons of singing.
Well, you were in that Pitch Perfect thing.
I sure was, yeah. I sang on the show. I know, I showed up and you made me sing on the show.
That's right. You did the deal with the cops.
I sure
which
did.
Which was fascinating, and you taught yourself to do that, and it's in the film. And now, have they made a second one, or they're going to make a second
one? Yeah, we made a second one that comes out later next year. And, I mean, I have to give you credit for turning that thing into...
Really?
That cup thing into a huge...
No, I think it was all... No, it was all you.
I've got a platinum record on my wall, like a Mary J. Blige or something. It's crazy.
Are you enjoying the holidays?
Very much, yeah. I'm going to stick around in New York for the holidays, I think.
Nice.
Yeah, it'll be my first time. Well, actually, it's kind of my first time spending any time here since I was totally broke. So I don't know what you...
You worked here as a kid early.
When I was a kid, when I was a teenager. But at that point in my life, I wasn't doing anything in New York. I mean, I wasn't like going out to eat or anything. I mean, my dad sent me a box of Cadbury eggs at Easter one year, and it was just supposed to be kind of a nice treat, but I lived off that bad boy for about a month.
Yeah. But see, this is good experience. I think for everybody to understand that life doesn't come to you, you have to go after life.
Agreed. Yeah. Well put.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, sometimes you have to ride a dirt bike into a Christmas tree. Just go for it.
Do you give a lot of stuff, or do you like to get a lot of stuff, or do you give a lot of stuff to get a lot of stuff?
I'm gonna go up to Maine see my family after Christmas. A couple days that we're gonna do Christmas after Christmas.
Christmas in Maine, is it idyllic?
It's gorgeous. It's absolutely gorgeous. I was just there for Thanksgiving, and we had a hell of a snowstorm that was really beautiful. It put the power out for a while, but you know, we just built a fire, forgot to open the flue, house filled up with smoke, you know, alarm going off. But it's other than that.
Yeah. You have to be very careful, because don't want to do that. Ben, you did it, and you learned your lesson.
I did,
I would think that living in Maine, you would know better.
My mom has a new house. I have no excuse. I don't know.
Blame it on mom.
Yeah, her new house.
Then do you know what you want for Christmas?
No, not really. Can I say, though, that cat toy, that is a fur-covered dildo, no? That's what that is. No, there was a factory. They were putting those out. They said, put a mitten on it and sell it to children. No?
Well.
Just, it's for kids now.
Whatever you want it to be, Anna. Can I have some cat toys, please? Can we? Wow, you know, that never, and I don't know what's the matter with me, but that never came to mind.
No, no.
Thank you very much, Brian. Merry Christmas.
Being sneaky with that, but we don't know.
Now that's all it is. I'm trying desperately to think of other things it might be, when in fact that's all it
actually is.
There you go, my friend. Don't worry about opening the flu. We'll be right back with Anna Kendrick. You're exactly right.
I shouldn't have said anything.
Because now
I shouldn't have said it.
I'm wondering if maybe Shannon didn't have enough stuff for toys.
That's what I'm saying. That's what
and
I'm saying.
Just on her way up here stopped into a specialty store.
Yep. Yep. We'll just give it to kids. It's no big deal. It's for children.
Were you in London last night?
I was, yeah. I just
So you did the overnight, or how does that work? You leave in the afternoon and you get here in the morning?
I don't know what time it is. Yeah. I don't know what's going on.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you for having me. I mean, I've got that London flight kind of down to a science because of Ambien.
Thank God for the sleep aid. Ambien.
It's a hell of a drug, though. Hell of a drug. I just sort of black out the second that I take it, and it's like I wake up to a surprise. Every time, like all my DVDs are in my fridge or something, like just a surprise.
So when you travel, you take it after you get on the plane?
Yeah. Well, this last time, because you have to be like ready to go to sleep. This last time I took it as soon as we took off, and I remember thinking, oh, I should put on something comfy to sleep in, and then nothing. And and when I woke up, I was wearing everything that was in my carry-on bag. And I had a 90-second video of my salad. not like an accident. Like I was uh-huh. Scorsese filming this salad. And the troubling thing about the everything in my carry-on was that I clearly had the thought, put on some sweatpants or something. It's a long flight, you know. But I thought, well, changing would be a hassle. It'll just go straight over the jeans, straight over the boots. So I had that first layer was my outfit I boarded in, and then sweatpants. And then I guess I must have thought, well, I like all these clothes. I mean, that's why I packed them. Yeah. So I'll just put them on.
I like this shirt.
I remember the shirt. Yeah. But it's nerve-wracking because was it a hurried process, you know, sort of sleepy and just doing it? Was I giving the other passengers a fashion show? I don't know. I'm not sure that I want to know. It's better that I don't know.
You were not asleep, but you were in some sort of hypnotic state.
No recollection of this happening.
Videotaping the salad and putting on
No recollection of putting DVDs
That's
in my
great.
Fridge or the one time I made enough scrambled eggs to feed a small army. It's like a time travel and a little surprise.
Well, a little surprise, yeah. And did you ever go to sleep during this?
Oh, yeah. No, I mean, I woke up.
You woke up.
I woke up, and I was like, well, that was good. What's happened to
oh,
me?
Oh, I see.
What have I done?
So you woke up refreshed and confused.
Yes.
Yes, the very best way.
Yeah.
So the movie Christmas Day, a lovely Christmas gift. To the people of the world, don't you think?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. We're going to show a clip here now of you as Cinderella. What are we going to see?
You're going to see me as Cinderella, doing Cinderella stuff. I don't know.
She doesn't remember. She was under the influence of Ambien during the filming. Let's take a look. It's Into the Woods. You can see it Christmas Day.
He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I'd run from him, he spread pitch on the stairs, and I'm caught unawares. Well, it means that he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock while you're standing here stuck on the steps of the palace.
Wow. The lovely Anna Kendrick, ladies and gentlemen.
What happened?
Very nice. Into the Woods. It's in theaters on Christmas Day. Enjoy the flight home.
Thank you.
We'll be right back with Charlie XCX, everybody.